Gifted Dyslexic, where learning is made easy. Dyslexics tend to be non-verbal thinkers.
With hindsight, I can see that I'm a non-verbal thinker, which is a word that I'll be using quite a lot in this lecture. Another word for a non-verbal thinker would be a dyslexic thinker. But I was not dyslexic, but I'm a dyslexic thinker. And there's a difference. I was a potential dyslexic, but because I'm one of the lucky ones, I had a teacher who knew how to teach me, who could accommodate my learning style, I never became dyslexic. I probably would have been diagnosed ADD as well if I had ever been diagnosed, but again, I was never diagnosed. Now, because my teacher really accommodated my learning style, I loved reading, and throughout my education, I was kind of effortlessly pretty much at the top of my class. And my peers often envied me a lot before exams, because I never revised for exams. What I did instead is I mastered what I was learning by paying attention in class.
Mastery goes beyond learning. When we learn to ride a bicycle, we actually master it, and that skill stays with us for the rest of our lives. A key component in mastery is focus.
I didn't quite know how I did it, but again, in hindsight, what I know, my coping strategy number one was my chair. I would balance on my chair. I was being in the back row, balancing on my chair against the backboard. We use that in Davis as a way of fine-tuning focus. We use balance to fine-tune focus. Oh, you all know that if you try to balance, if you're not focused, you lose your balance. If you're drunk, you'll struggle with balancing. It's because when you're drunk, you're disorientated. And the key component in dyslexia is disorientation, and you'll see more about that as we go through.
For non-verbal thinkers, there are two modes of thinking. Orientation, or external focus, which is good for accurate perception, and disorientation, or internal focus, which is good for high-speed processing. For more information, and for booking assessments, interventions, and lectures, please visit www.gifteddyslexic.com.